This is Manaksha Balakrishnan. Welcome back to my class on integration. Integration by substitution. Again, now we are going to see the second example. Say, let me take integral log x whole square divided by x dx. Right? So here we are going to do the integration by substitution. Let t is equal to log x. Right? So now dt by dx, if I differentiate t with respect to x, log x derivative is 1 by x. So we get dt to be equal to 1 by x dx. So our integral I is simply equal to, in the place of log x I can substitute t, so it becomes t square, and then dx by x, you can notice that it is just dt. So integral t square dt, and it's very simple formula. We know the formula. What is the formula? Integral x power n dx is x raised to the power of 1 to the divided by n plus 1. So, plus a constant. So, we need to increase the power by 1 and divide by the power which we have increased. So, t squared integration then is, it is t power 3, 2 plus 1. T power 3 divided by 3 plus a constant. Here, if we replace t's value, we end up with the solution. So t's value is log x. So it is log x whole to the power 3 by 3 plus c. That's it. So it's very simple. Right? Now, let me give another example where sometimes in thinking or bringing up the idea becomes slightly difficult. So two examples so far we have seen. The two examples are simpler ones. I'm going to take up the next one. It's not quite difficult, but just the getting the idea is going to be something different, right? So let me give the third example. Say, it is a simple one, but just only in terms of idea it is different. Say, let me take a problem of this kind, 1 divided by x minus root x, right? So in this case we don't get initially the idea of the substitution t, but whereas we need to do certain algebraic work. So here, if I take root x as a common term, say consider x minus root x. So if I take root x as a common term, then root x times root x is x. So inside the parenthesis, I have root x minus 1. Right? So first we do this simplification. Right? So our integral now becomes equal to integral 1 divided by root x times root x minus 1. Now basically substituting this root x minus 1 under t, so put t is equal to root x minus 1. Now dt by dx is 1 divided by 2 root x dx. Root x derivative is 1 by 2 root x, right? So sorry, this dx should not come. Okay, so here already I have done dt by dx, right? So if I bring this dx, now you get dx over here. So this is dt is 1 by 2 root x dx. Notice here you find dx divided by root x. I don't find 2 here. So I can just bring this 2 here to the left, so that it is twice dt is 1 by root x dx. So this ends up our complication. So now the integral becomes as simple as this, right? So this is our integral. I have also written here. So I is equal to, already let me repeat, rewrite what we have written earlier. This is root x times root x minus 1, okay, dx. Okay, now all we need to do is just match our substitutions. Root x minus 1, we have taken it as t. So I can write this portion as 1 by t. Now dx divided by root x, notice dx divided by root x, here it is 2 dt. So let us write 2 dt. So it's again a simple integral formula. So let me take 2 outside the integral. So it is simply integral 1 by t dt. So the answer to this is twice log absolute value of t plus c. So if we just replace the value of t, t is here, t is root x minus 1. So root x minus 1 modulus plus c. So that's the solution for this integral. So two examples we have seen in this session. The one was easier, the second one is also easier. Only thing is that before substitution we need to do a part of simplification. Thank you for watching, and in next section we'll see some more examples.